I am José Cunha Vaz. I am from Portugal. My university town, university is Coimbra in Portugal, in the center of Portugal. Now, my main interest has been clinical research. We are coordinating a network of clinical trial centers across Europe, 102 centers, and is something like the DRCRNet, but is not funded by the NIH, is European, and but it's, we think, very important development for European research, for clinical research, and to do across the border clinical trials. My main field of interest has been retina and diabetic retinopathy. Two things, you can summarize only two things, OCT and treatment availability with anti-VEGFs. This has really completely revolutionized the DME treatment. I was still a PI in Chicago at the laser, when the laser started to treat and was shown that it was effective in slowing the progress of the retinopathy, and that was a major step forward. Nowadays we are much better off and we have better options, and that's why medical retina has become such an active field with lots of new findings, new studies, and better options for our patients. What I think the major problem is the individuality of the patient. Not necessarily the patients are not the same. The patients we are finding and working in our work has shown that you have fast progressors, and which are about 25% of the ones with mild retinopathy, whereas 75% do not progress rapidly. And to identify these patients is a major challenge. Now, even in these patients, the next challenge is to know which ones really are going to progress more rapidly and how effective treatment, and not all respond to treatment. And this individuality, this how can we characterize that patient is really my major challenge at the moment. However, it's important notion, because then you understand that this is not something that you can use a cookbook and say, yeah, for these patients, let's use this treatment. And that shows how the complexity still of the answers and the responses. I think new drugs are coming. New options. It's always better to have three options than one. And if you have five, even better. Gives you more time to think, but still, it's better for our patients, which is our major concern anyway. And therefore, if we can offer better solutions with less complications, we are happy with the idea, and it's very important for ophthalmology and for medical retina. And I think they are in the horizon, and we see them coming. And you see better understanding of what's going on. And for instance, one major issue, I believe more and more that in diabetic retinopathy is endothelial, and in diabetic macular edema is endothelial dysfunction because of barrier breakdown, accumulation of fluid, abnormal fluid, and is the endothelial dysfunction happening in the vessels of the retina. We still don't treat that as directly. We treat that indirectly. And therefore, factors involved are probably more than 10, and we are only treating one or two, you know. We are a long way still to go, but better off than before.